Moms who know do less so they can focus on what matters most, taking care of themselves, their families, and living their God-given purpose. Moms who know focus on the little things they can do that grow to have a huge impact. You are connecting with your family, your true self, and your God-given purpose. You are a mom who knows. Hello and welcome to the Moms Who Know podcast. I'm your host, Chanel Nielsen, and this is a one little thing bonus episode with Ceri Payne. Ceri, thanks so much for being with us.
Thanks for having me.
Ceri is a life coach, and she has some really good things to share in these tumultuous, uncertain times. And I think that a lot of us are feeling really similar emotions. I sent out an email to my list just yesterday and asked, how are you guys doing? And to those of you who replied, I tried to reply to everyone. I have some I still need to answer today, but I will reply to everyone. I just want you to know we're all in this together. I'm thinking about you. We are going to get through this. And Ceri is here to help us with a few thoughts and really actionable tips to help us kind of adjust to our current normal. So to start off with, Ceri, talk to us a little bit about, we're all dealing with a lot of emotions, a lot of anxiety, I'd say, for most of us. What can we expect? Let's talk first about ourselves and then a little bit about our children. So what can we expect from ourselves as we're dealing with this?
I think for ourselves, of course, we can expect that we are going to feel a gamut of the emotions A through Z, right? There's just, and it's going to be totally normal. And what we want to do is to expect ourselves to allow us to feel the emotion and just recognize it and know it's there. Don't try to talk yourself out of it or even your children out of that emotions that we are being felt. We could definitely expect that our emotions may be a little bit more exaggerated. As parents, we may notice that we're showing up a little more irritated or less patience than normal. We might be feeling a little bit more overwhelmed. Same thing with our kids. You know, they may mirror all those same things, but they may be more easily bored or quieter than usual or less social with John. So just notice that the emotions may be a little bit more exaggerated. And also as parents, really don't try to second guess or understand why your child might be acting a certain way. Just really do your best just to stay understanding, stay compassionate, and just stay curious. Because ultimately, you know, we don't know what's going through their little minds and we don't really know what they're truly worried about. So we may be noticing like a bunch of tears or a bunch of aggression or just attitude or whatever over like homework, having to do homework. And we don't know if it's because they're missing their friends or if it's because they really don't understand the material and they're feeling inadequate, or if they are scared that they're not going to learn everything they need to learn and be prepared for next year. Or maybe they're scared because they are afraid that we might be sick or that they might get sick or that we might die. And, you know, just on the same note for us, just notice that we act very differently to the same emotions. So what I have noticed for me that when I'm mad, it's not just a one-way emotion. Sometimes when I'm mad, my actions may be that I might yell or I might cry or I might be really withdrawn and go to my room and hide, or I might really be kind of loud and call my sister and complain. Sometimes when I'm mad, I might, you know, bake cookies or even go to sleep without any dinner. So just notice that the different reactions or the different actions that we have, they are all displayed for the same feeling. And this is true for our kids, for our spouse, for our family members. So just not to try to interpret them, but just to show up with love and compassion for these emotions that we are feeling and our children might be feeling.
Oh, that's such a good point, because a lot of times we do try to interpret and we, you know, take certain things to mean certain other things when they don't necessarily. And I love this idea of kind of taking a step back and, you know, just being okay with all the emotions and however they're playing out. And that kind of, you know, it can be hard to do. How do we help our kids through those emotions when we don't even know what they're about?
That's a great question. So the best thing that we can do, I think, for our children and their emotions is just recognize that they must be thinking something that's causing them pain, right? So this emotion that maybe the outburst or whatever, it's probably an emotion, right? Something that they're thinking, and it may not be about the actual situation. It's nice to remind ourselves that it's not our jobs to fix it. It's not our jobs to talk them out of their emotions and just allow them to have them, right? If they're obviously not harming themselves or others, but you know, if they're crying or if they're upset, don't feel like we need to fix it and talk them out of it. Allow them to have it. Again, be understanding, show up for them as best as you know how, as best as we're able to during this time. And we're not going to be perfect and we're going to have our flaws and not, but just show up as best as you know how. And then the last thing is just always remember that emotions are contagious. So if we're scared, if we're fearful, right, we may show up differently than normal. We may show up less patient for our children and they're going to sense that. And so most often they're going to mirror or react to our emotions. And again, they may not mirror it in the exact same way because we all react differently to our emotions. But when they're acting up, maybe ask, you know, like, how am I showing up? Are they possibly, you know, mirroring or reacting to my emotions?
So true. It's so true. They really do pick up on the things that we're feeling. And even if we think, oh, I'm handling this pretty good, or I'm, you know, putting on a brave face in front of the kids, that's not necessarily what they pick up on. They do pick up on that underlying emotion. Now, I'm going to admit that for me, one of the underlying things that I have going on is this need to, I feel like, okay, you know, I've got some free time. I don't have to run everybody around and I'm not worried about schedules and I have more help with my three-year-old. So I can get all this stuff done for the podcast. And yet I kind of find myself wandering around the house and like not getting to it like I should. And then I feel bad and I'm putting a little pressure on myself. So how can we kind of balance that? The need to use our time well and the grace to not put too much pressure on ourselves.
Yeah, this is the golden question, right? And so I apologize in advance. I could talk about it for hours, but I won't. But no matter what we're going, whatever is going on in the world, whether it's just, you know, our normal, traditional, quote unquote, whatever that is, life versus now, the best way to use our time well is to use it intentionally, which means we actually have to plan it. So as we plan, what we want to think through is, what is it that we want to accomplish that day? And we ask ourselves that question by saying, what is the results that we want for this day? And when we create our schedule, what are the results that we are aiming for? So of course, right now, our schedules may look a little bit differently as we are navigating through this, you know, uncertainty and this social distancing. But what we don't want to do is put that extra pressure on ourselves to be perfect. We don't want to make sure that it's not our job to make sure our kid passes all of fifth grade in one quarter, or that they do an hour of PE and a science experiment and a craft daily. So, I mean, do whatever you want, but you want to do what makes you sane, what promotes happiness, what promotes that feelings of contentment. And the number one thing that I'm noticing as I've been working with my clients over the last week or so are these unrealistic expectations of the school time being from like 8 to 3. Because even in a traditional school setting, instructional time is only about 4 hours. And that's like whole group instruction, which takes much longer than one-on-one instruction to begin with. And then that rest of that traditional school day, they have social time and recess and, you know, read alouds and lunch and extracurriculars. So we aren't trying to recreate this traditional school experience right now. What are we trying to do? Like, what is your R line? You know, and it might just be that you're trying to, and when I say R line, sorry, that's my vernacular. What is your result that you want for yourself? And we're just trying to keep life going as best as we can. And just reminding ourselves, yeah, we do have lots of time that's different. It looks different, but it's not going to last forever. So what do you want to accomplish for you and for your family during this time? And you ask yourself, what's the feeling that you want to feel during this time? So is your schedule creating that? Like, you want to feel that feeling of maybe fun or productive or connected, but is your schedule allowing those feelings that you want, or is it causing you to feel stressed and busy and overwhelmed? So the main thing what we want to do is remind ourselves to really keep it simple. Don't create a schedule that overwhelms you and makes you feel behind before you even begin. I know a lot of people, as you mentioned, they feel like they have a lot of time and, you know, things got canceled. And so they already just start thinking and thinking and thinking, and their schedule is already getting so full in their own head that they're setting themselves up to fail because they're just feeling behind before the day even starts. So allow your schedule to provide structure and those feelings of contentment and direction, but you don't want your schedule to, you know, disempower you or make you feel like you're behind and overwhelm you.
Oh, I think that's so good, because I think the more that we can simplify and come down to what do I want to feel and then what does that lead me to do, that's going to just set us up to win the day instead of these feelings of overwhelm that you mentioned and feeling like, oh my gosh, I have so much to do and I'm not getting it done. And that sets us up to really feel like we're not doing enough, we're not making it, you know, this, and it continues that cycle of anxiety.
Exactly. Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So many good things already. I would love to finish off with this. We are experiencing something most of us have never experienced before, and all of us have never experienced to this level. I know some moms already had their kids home. Some moms already were homeschool kids, and yet there's a totally different element for everyone, even if your day-to-day looks similar. So what hidden opportunities are there for us during these unprecedented times?
I like to remind people that what we focus on is what gets our attention. So what are the feelings that you're focusing on? What are the thoughts that you're focusing on? Because that's where then you are going to focus your attention, and that's what you're going to take away from this time. So with that, I like to encourage people to, you know, look for the silver lining, look for the blessings, and look for the good in all of this. A client mentioned to me in a session just last week, like how hard it was to have all the kids home, to keep them occupied, to keep them from fighting. But then she said, it is so nice sleeping in, and the quiet family dinners have been enjoyable too. And so I just wanted to, like, you know, remind her and remind you, like, what is it that you're enjoying about this time that you want to focus on? Another client was really worried about all of her college age kids coming back into the home and all the dynamics of that. And in the very same sentence of this worry, she says, it's going to be so fun to have them all under the same roof again, because that hasn't happened in a lot of years. And then she said how she was looking forward to the older kids playing with the little ones and helping them with their schoolwork and planning crafts. And so it's just, when it feels hard and when you get frustrated and overwhelmed, stop and take a deep breath and ask yourself, what is good about this time? What is different about this time that you're enjoying? And then ask yourself, are you focusing on what's making this time memorable? Because even in the normal, quote unquote, normal life, right? We have like half good and half like less than desirable. And so this time, of course, is no different. And sure, it's like a little more unexpected and unpredictable and maybe even a little scarier. But there's also really good, and there's fun, and there's memories, and there's things being made. And so just really focus on those things, so that when you're going to bed at night and you might feel overwhelmed and exhausted, and our brain sometimes plays all the things that were bad and all the things that are horrible and that we're not looking forward to, just stop for a second and re-ask your brain, but what was good about today?
I love that. I think that's good advice for always, but especially for right now. We get to choose what we're going to focus on. And the more we look for the good, absolutely, the more we will find it. So Ceri, thank you so much for being with us. I love the things that you've shared.
Thanks for having me. It was truly my pleasure.
And thank you everyone for listening to Moms Who Know. I hope that episode was helpful for you. And I know that a lot of us are feeling so many emotions. I love the thought that Ceri shared, just to feel those emotions, to be okay with that. If you want to get more from Ceri, I'm going to send you to a couple of different places. The first is momswhoknowpodcast.com. If you go to blog, she wrote an amazing guest post called 4 Ways to Get on the Path to Excellence that you guys should definitely check out. Or you can find her on Instagram at organizedlife.coach. Thank you for being here. I appreciate you guys listening, and I wish you all the best, and we'll see you next time on Moms Who Know.